there is no more important currency in a young boy's life of our age than to have some sort of crappy VCR version of Kiss meets Phantom of the Park.
Yeah, it's totally true.
If you had that, you were golden.
Dude, do you know how many times I got laid when I was 9 years old because I had that?
After doing really what is now four kind of bigger production studio records, we kind of thinking about, okay, what's the next step? Because we've done all of these records as a trio, and you know, it just seemed like it was time to shake things up a bit.
Yeah, we started toying with the idea for the new Bad Plus record to work with a singer, to bring in another person for, you know, to be for a collaboration.
It had to be somebody who was more of a rock singer. We weren't really interested in finding like a jazz singer.
We were in New York and we were feeling frustrated about thinking about who we would think about working with. We were naming all these people, and then Reed, who was a fan of the band that Wendy and I did, brought up Wendy, and it made immediate sense to me.
I was listening to this in the car, driving down the highway, and I turned to my husband and I was like, this is Dave King, he wants me to do a record with the Bad Plus. And he was like, are you kidding? And I'm like, no, I don't think he's kidding, but you know Dave, he's a kidder. You know, I think Dave wanted me involved because we have a similar kind of sensibility about things.
Weird prog bluesy odd time weird, she's just into all this out shit. It's like PJ Harvey with odd time signatures and with a lot of improvising. There was a constant affirmation of our taking the risk, believing she would be the right person. It was much more like she was, again, really, her idea from the get-go was to make it right as a Bad Plus record. Her idea was to, like, how can I get inside what we do, or what this band does, and not sit on top of it singer style.
It's come together really well, because I think, I mean, I understand it, it makes sense to me.
It also opened the door as being an all-interpretations record for us to record some of the contemporary classical music we've been playing. So, I mean, it's not an all-vocal record.
That a lot of the best electronica artists like Aphex Twin, there's something about their harmonic and melodic language that reminds me of neoclassic Stravinsky. And so we take this beautiful Stravinsky slow movement and put a gentle electronica beat to it.
I think one of the coolest things about working with these guys is the deconstructing, reconstructing part of the process is fascinating.
I I think this band is really always about playing the song, whether it's our original music or whether it's appropriating someone else's music. This is a way to kind of make it even more clear what we're doing, you know, and celebrate and really have it be really about the song with a great singer like this. And
honey, I hope you can there is something shrugging.